This video shows you how to invite users to Qlik Cloud. The individual who creates the tenant is the service account owner. If you are the service account owner, you are also the first tenant administrator and the only user with access to the tenant. You can add more users in two ways, by configuring an identity provider or by sending email invitations. If you have an IDP, you can create an IDP configuration in the Identity Provider section. If you do not have an IDP, you can add users by sending invite emails. You can invite users to join the tenant by sending email invitations from the Users pane in the Management Console or from your User Profile menu. Click Invite User, and then in the Invitation window, you can list multiple email addresses separated by a comma or a space. To send an email invitation, you must be a tenant administrator. You can see the invitation by selecting Pending Invites in the drop-down list to the left. Hover over the invite to see the expiry date. Invites that have expired are shown in red in the table. Opening the menu, you can resend an invitation if needed. When you invite a user, they will receive an email that contains a link, which is only valid for a limited period. When the user clicks the button, an account registration page is opened. The user must fill in the form to set up an account. Once the user has registered, they can log in to Qlik Cloud. When the user has registered, the status changes to active. For each user, you can open a menu where you can assign and remove security roles, change user entitlement, activate or disable users, revoke mobile access if it has been granted, and delete users. Each user has a status depending on whether they are a fully registered user, a user who has been invited but not yet registered, or a user who has been disabled. You can select a status to filter by in the drop-down list. These are the available statuses. Active, the user is fully registered. They can use the product according to their assigned roles. Disabled, the user entitlement is removed. The user cannot access their account or use the product. Provisioned, the user is invited but is not yet registered. The user ID is created but no entitlement has been assigned. Orphans, the user has been assigned an entitlement to their IDP subject from the license service. The user has not yet registered and no user ID has been created. The tenant admin can delete active users or pending users from the Users section in the Management Console. In the row for the user to be deleted, open the menu and select Delete to delete an existing user. Deleting an active user frees up a user entitlement that can be assigned to another user. You can also delete an invitation. To do that, open the menu and select Delete Invitation. Deleting a pending user removes the user record from the system, and they won't be able to register through an email invitation. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.